Hi friends, the topic of our discussion is the difference between antigen and antibody. First of all, starting with the definition. Antigen is any foreign substance that is capable of interacting with the immune system and is capable of eliciting an immune response. Suppose this is a bacterium, there are many antigenic determinants on the surface of bacterium. On the other hand, antibodies are globular proteins or immunoglobulins that react specifically with antigen that stimulated its production. So this is a bacterium. Antibodies are specifically targeted against a specific antigenic determinant. There is a constant race between antigen and antibody similar to that of prey-predator relationship. Antibodies are involved in our defense system that is actually protecting us from diseases, whereas antigens are the disease-causing agents. And there is a constant battle, 24/7 battle, and we'll be discussing in detail how these two molecules differ and what makes a difference. Difference number one. This is a clear-cut definition. Any substance or molecule that interact with antibodies or by T-cell receptor when complex with MHC are called as antigens. Antigens include cell wall components of bacteria, capsules, flagella, toxins, viral proteins, bacteria, other microbes, etc. Theoretically, any foreign body that is capable of eliciting an immune response can be called as an antigen. Whereas on the other hand, antibodies are immunoglobulins synthesized by plasma cells of B cells that react specifically with antigen that stimulated its production. There are millions of antibodies inside our body that is specifically designed against different antigens in the surroundings. Difference number two. Chemically, antigens are generally proteins, but can be carbohydrates, lipids, or even nucleic acids. In the case of viruses, maybe carbohydrate polysaccharides can be antigenic. Bacterial polysaccharides are antigenic. These are some exceptions. Basically, they are proteins. Whereas antibodies, on the other hand, are glycoproteins made up of proteins and small amount of carbohydrates. Difference number three. Antigenic structure is highly complex in structure and composition. They differ greatly. It may be simple to complex. You can see these are different antigens, different shape, different molecular weight, different immunogenicity. Many properties differ. And each antigen will interact with a specific antibody. This interaction is highly specific. Whereas in the case of antibody, individual units are Y-shaped structure consisting of four polypeptide chains, two heavy chain and two light chain that is joined by disulfide bond. And this is the structure, a Y-shaped structure consisting of two heavy chain and two light chain. And these chains are joined by disulfide bonds in between. Small amount of carbohydrates are also present. And this region constitutes the antigen binding site. There are two antigen binding sites in an individual unit, and this is called as the constant region or the FC region. And this variable region determines the specificity of an antibody. Difference number four. The region of the antigen that interacts with the antibodies is called as epitopes. A pathogen has many epitopes. Suppose this is a bacterium, and this bacterium has many epitopes or antigenic determinants that can interact specifically with different antibodies. This is the epitope number one, that is an antibody that is specifically directed against this epitope. And this is epitope two, a different antibody that can fit this epitope will be synthesized by the system. And this is epitope number three, where yet another different antibody will be produced specifically against this epitope. A single pathogen may be having a number of epitopes. On the other hand, antibody is a variable region of the antibody that specifically binds with the epitope of an antigen is called as a paratope. Generally, a Y-shaped antibody like IgG or individual monomeric unit has two identical paratopes. And this is the structure of antigen, this is a Y-shaped structure. This is the antigen binding site, and this yellow colored is a variable region, and here the amino acids are highly specific, and these amino acids can recognize the antigen that fits here. And there is a high specificity. This region is called as a paratope. Paratope lies in the FAB region or antigen binding region. Difference number five. Antigens are actually causing diseases or allergic reactions, whereas antibodies are involved in our defense system. They are the master molecules that is protecting us from diseases, and they are continuously working 24/7 for protecting us from all infectious pathogens surrounding us. Protection is offered by immobilization or lysis agglutination precipitation of antigenic material. And this is one way. Either by neutralization, suppose this is a bacterium and antigens will bound to this bacterium and actually neutralizing it. And toxins secreted by this bacterium and also antigen will bound all around these toxins and actually neutralizing it. And other way is opsonization. This will bound and actually causing the macrophages to phagocytose the pathogen entirely, causing the destruction of the pathogen. And third way is agglutination. These antibodies will bind to the pathogen and causing clumping. As a result, immune cells will clear the site. Clumping often results in other immune cells may get alerted and they will reach the site and clear the site, and this results in elimination of pathogen from the site. And these are different ways by which antibodies clear antigens from the system. And thank you so much for your support. Please share, subscribe and like. And you have it biologyexamsforyou.com. Thank you so much for watching.